brook trout. New York state fish, and arguably one of the most beautiful and highly respected freshwater species by anglers. Unfortunately, their populations have been largely impacted by the effects of acid rain and competition from non-native fish. To ensure their presence in New York and to help re-establish self-sustaining populations, they need a little help. And that's what brings us to the heart of the Adirondacks on this unusually sunny November morning. In New York, there are three original or heritage strains of brook trout that DEC actively manages and stocks in the Adirondack Park. Today, staff are collecting the Windfall Pond strain. Fishery staff start by setting trap nets that run from the shoreline to about 5 feet of water. The trap has a long leader that fish swim into, where they're then guided into a holding trap called a car. After 2 days, fish are ready to be collected. Staff retrieve the fish from the trap nets and bring them to shore. They are then separated into many tubs by sex and readiness to spawn. Eggs are gently massaged out of the female trout, while milt is collected from the males to fertilize the eggs in small bowls. After the females are spawned, length measurements are taken so biologists can estimate how many eggs have been taken so far. This allows them to figure out how many females they need to collect without getting too many eggs. After fish have been processed, they're released back into the pond. Fertilized eggs are placed into small coolers and sterilized with an iodine mixture to ensure they're clean of any diseases. After 30 minutes, the eggs are rinsed with spring water and transferred to a DEC hatchery where they'll spend the winter, eventually hatching into small fish called fry. Come fall, they'll be around 5 inches and ready to take a trip in a helicopter where they'll be air stocked into lakes and ponds throughout the Adirondacks. To ensure our egg take and stocking efforts are as productive as possible, some brook trout ponds have barrier dams constructed at the outlet. These dams prevent non-native fish from entering and altering the fish community, which could potentially disrupt brook trout from spawning. This is also why bait fish are prohibited in brook trout ponds. All of these management efforts together will protect brook trout while providing quality brook trout fishing for years to come. For more information on brook trout management and stocking information, visit the DEC website.